Alrighty. Your face on a pretty good team on Monday Night Football. Seattle Seahawks. We've played them a couple times. Lost one playoff game to him. Other than that, did pretty well. But overall, I think he's 2-5 at this point in the season, or something like that. But though the defense is tough, and yeah, 2-5. So looking forward to. Hopefully a successful game. Haven't played them in this year's Madden yet. So it'll be interesting. I know he's got some tall corners. I know he's made a massive overhaul of the team. He's got some tall corners who are a bit on the slow side, so might have the opportunity to exploit that with Cordero. Hello, with the stats, I'm surprisingly almost with him in passing yards. And the turnover differentials, substantial. Looking forward to a good game. I know the few times I've played him, he's with the Seahawks, he's done a pretty good job of slowing down the run. And I don't know, I mean, that could be a product of just him, or it could be a product of Seattle. But either way, I've had some difficult times running the ball. As always, first play of the game, misdirection. Peterson alone in the backfield. He'll get the football here. And he'll get this up over the 25 and the 26. If that corner would have held or been completely blocked, I think I would have been able to break that for a long one. But either way, it's all good. Had to change the direction pretty much immediately from where I was going to go because that end right there, he got free. They run again with Peterson, and they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. They get five out of that one. All right, we're gonna. I don't know which side Sherman is on. I assume he's on the left side. All right, we're gonna go for my shot play here. It's a bit early, but we'll see. I think Sean Smith is over on the left. He is. Okay. So if he comes down, I don't see that safety. I'm just going to chop this. Looks like he might be in cover two zone. Okay. Dang it. The safety, Earl Thomas, he didn't go over where I, or he didn't go over to protect deep. But I saw Smith, where he's like 15, 20 yards off, and I knew that I wasn't going to be able to get anything deep there, so I just took the easy first down. Cliff Averill, he's right now he's abusing Cordy Glenn, haven't been able to block him really at all so far. That could change, obviously. Seeing some of these scores, I'm very surprised. Right there, Joker lost to Stang. I mean, Stang's been playing great defense. Cheese Jr., he's, I think, 7-1, and he's got the highest scoring, offense in all of AFL. I mean, can't take anything away from him. Oh, no. I got lucky right there. I thought he was going to turn and run, and obviously he did not. Man, a little bit of luck. But you always need a little bit to be successful. I just need to go to Matthews to get that block over there. Okay. I could have used that guard even feigning a block. And he didn't even do that. I like this play. That out route is pretty good. If the guy turns off or comes off a bit. Ah, crap. Oh, that was a great defensive call for the play. 3rd and 4. I'm gonna go spread and just try and run this. See if he gives me a five man box. All right, that's. Man, that's a risky run. I'm gonna get out of it. I'm gonna call play action though. Fortunately, I got him to come up a little bit and just attack the vacated area. On this play, I'm gonna go with their ISO. But I've been running left. Avril's been getting off Cordy Glenn. So I'm gonna try to run this ISO right at his user. Hopefully put him in a precarious position. Oh, well, the user's not there. Okay. He was on the safety that time. It doesn't really happen often with rain. I'm going to go with stick here. That safety's down, so I'm not going to really attack the flats here. I'm going to be looking at the slant, most likely. Get it. Okay. That needed to be quicker. And I didn't get it out. All right, I'm gonna go with pistol here. I'm gonna try and run the strong power. I think he's gonna be covering Wagner. And okay, he's gonna cover Wagner. I don't think he's gonna get me out there. Oh my gosh! See, I pressed inside long enough to get the guy to commit. And I was gonna just break outside while my guy was sealing outside, and he did not, or what rather, he did, and I didn't cut out well enough. I mean, it's disappointing to not get a touchdown because that was gonna be 6. But I mean, getting points at all is fine. His offense, I've only seen a few videos, or not videos, but streams, and I mean it's about what you'd expect from Vane. I've seen him attack with drags and. I'm not gonna say that to. I've only watched maybe 3 or 4 drives of him, so I'm not gonna say he's a drag master. But I know Mike Evans is a problem, so that's something that I have to consider here. I'm gonna spotlight Mike Evans here. I hit sick with Holly on that one, and I really should not have. I really didn't need to, because I didn't. One, Holly is slow, and two, I didn't have outside leverage to force him back inside. I was just hit sticking on the hopes that he would just cut back into Holly for no apparent reason. My offensive drive lasted a while, it seems. Seems like these drives are, but these games are going by a lot quicker than earlier in Madden, because it seems like I'm not getting very many drives over the course of the game anymore. Alright, here's that formation. I'm going to watch the counter. Okay. Well, he almost messed up. Then he ended up running into a guy. Then he sort of messed up again. That was almost a long play. From a 1 yard gain into a 6 yard gain, just by stumbling. He's becoming more of a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys going to want to run up and tackle him. Ah, shoot. That was my fault. Okay, guys. Tackle him.
Let me tell you know that expression, I feel you, feel your pain. I felt Jimmy's when it happened. Now mine didn't
cover through Buster here. He threw that too fast. Call C4. Not gonna do that. Never mind. Third and eight, third and nine. This is the point where I think I'm going to spotlight Mike Evans. And then I'm going to spotlight Mike Evans, and I'm going to try and watch. Never mind. No need to. That was a very conservative call. Wonder if he's going to. Never mind, he's not.
Being any bigger than your first NFL touchdown, and this rookie running back is still seeking his. He's not going to get it on that play.
I guess he might have been expecting me to be on the linebacker. So I guess that would more or less affect the decision making. Second drive of the game. Pistol counter. Because that's what you get when you put the ball in the end zone. But there are benefits to that type of a long drive. Your defense gets a chance to take a break. Hopefully I can get a block on the edge on Avril. Oh my gosh. couldn't get a guy block inside. That was, see, normally, I mean, I could get to the outside. I tried to keep it inside to cut inside of the block on Averill, and the guy that was obviously Reed, he came straight down and got in the way and forced me to run into my guy and then run into him. Close cross. My fault. I was going to wait to see what he was going to do, but I didn't have that time, being in Gillette. Number of Cordero's. Can't get him over there either. Okay. I expect I expect some variation in cover two man or C4. Third and 19. It's I don't have a lot of plays for that, surprisingly.
Big sack on second down. Now the offense needs to convert here on third.
It looks like cover two man at this point. I'll cover the three man up. Oh my gosh. That was poorly thrown because Jordan Matthews got off of him off the press. So he had him and then he just didn't get anything with it. Pitiful. So now, it's not two straight games without a touchdown in the first half. Had the drag covered, and then I had the in route covered. I'm gonna run this cover one because he doesn't have too many speed wide receivers, so I don't expect to get beat deep unless he calls a tight formation. Then I shan't. All right. Oh man. You have the tackle. That's two very conservative plays on third down. That's interesting. Lets me know that he's, you know, trying to play a little bit conservative, or rely on the defense, and that it makes sense considering the team. Really? All right. Seconds. Pretty sure he gets the ball out of the half, too. What to do? I really hate that this formation doesn't come up the correct way. Gotta get a little bit of movement. Oh my gosh, took another sack. That's being stupid. Yeah, it was just me just being really dumb. And all, of course, the offensive line not holding their blocks. Oh, Lord have mercy. I'm going to threw that right to Wagner. This defensive line is just abusing us right now. And there isn't really anything to say at this point. Going to run the ball here. No way. Wow. Oh, man. I would be so upset if I was Vane right now. Damn. Played that absolutely perfectly. And then... Adrian Peterson does. Oh, you know, I mean, not taking any credit away from myself. I did make the proper move afterwards. After the initial break tackle, I was able to stop for a brief moment. And then get to the outside, but I absolutely did not expect him to break that. But I certainly will take it.
And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. They start on the ground with Rawls. There's a flag on the play. And he gets this one to midfield before.
Oh, man.
So thanks to the late touchdown, it's a time ball.
I have to make sure to watch that damn play again. That was pretty ridiculous. I'm sorry, Nino. That was... It should not have happened. Now it's a freaking brand new game thanks to that... the craziness. I've had, a bit of an issue getting stops over the last couple games. Seems that whenever I get into a third down yardage, I get a little bit worse. Fortunately, I've been able to bend and not break. If I don't get a sack, it seems like my opponents end up in third and four, third and five, and then I just don't get a stop. Oh my gosh, man. Thomas Rawls. Granted, I did try to hit stick him with a corner, which is probably the last thing you want to do with an individual that is of high strength and high truck. But hey, going out there giving our all. My fifth pick. A little bit of a punt safe here. I don't think he's going to fake it, but you never know. Wow. Can't believe that freaking dude got that. Okay. First play. Dime, I think. It was dime. So that was the time I should have went against what I normally do. I should have just ran straight dive. But being the creature of habit that I am, I went ahead and just stuck with it, regardless. The zone flip. Third and inches. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna look at this play. I'm either gonna run power zero or a toss. Depends on where the linebackers are lined up. Like right now, I'm looking at a toss because the corner's back. And the linebacker's not outside the defensive end. Yo, how is Sean Smith catching Adrian Peterson? Come on now. It shouldn't happen. But it's all right. We run this undergo. Force his middle linebacker into a decision. Nice drop, my friend. That was cover two also. I should have took the seam. The seam is gonna be open there. I'm gonna go with P.A. Reed. But if he's controlling the middle linebacker again, I expect him to get sucked into this play action. Ah, shoot. Jeez Louise. That went 3rd and 10. I don't want any problems with Mr. Earl Thomas. So if there was even a hint that he could have read the correct play, I was not going to take that chance. I've seen Earl do some pretty amazing things. We're on a screen here. Oh, can my guys get one block? Just one. That's all it took on that one. Just one. I mean, he didn't read the play correctly as a user, and... Oh, man, this is going to be tough. Oh, that's off. Massively. Oh, Jesus. I anticipated it coming back a lot quicker than that, obviously. Oh, jeez, that was awful. Okay, back to the old drawing board. That's me, guys. I got extremely sucked in. And unfortunately, he still had the time to get the DR route off. So I don't know why I'm attacking the run like that. That's the second time I got caught. That's the second time I got caught on play action like that. I don't know why I'm biting so hard. It's not like I'm getting gassed.
And
This will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Now the Bills offense gets
disappointing
to head back onto the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard.
I mean, this is the most amount of points I've given up in a few weeks. I think Trump scored 20 on me. Disappointing. Okay. So I'm gonna go with this play action screen. Hopefully he's in zone. It looks like it at this point. Ay ay ay, man. These guys are not getting their blocks at the point of attack, or right on the edge, right at the line of scrimmage. I mean, that's what's keeping us from getting anything going. There's some lack of blocking. Now the 3rd and 5. Okay. I absolutely did not expect that ball to be caught. Mainly because I thought it was extremely underthrown and off target. And I didn't think anything because I was about to go at T-Mobile. And surprisingly, Cordero got to it. Come on now. How does Incognito and my fullback run right past him? I mean, they both bumped him. They both bumped the guy and just didn't block him. See. Good Matthews in the spot. I'm gonna send him on a slant. And if I see him inch over to the right, I might go to it.
On second down, Taylor. He targets Jordan Matthews and it's gone. They'll wind up getting 11 on that one.
3rd and 2. I'm gonna look at this ISO. See how it's looking pre-play. See whether he wants to commit to a side. Right now the right side looks mighty fine. It's a matter of if he's going to pick up block the point of attack. We got him. We're going to call a toss here. I'm gonna get out of the toss here. The linebacker. No, never mind. I'm gonna leave it. Oh, I should not have left it. That was my fault. See, I knew with the linebacker on the edge, if he wasn't blitzing, he was gonna. The fact that he was blitzing obviously made this screwed up the entire play because he got in the back a little. 2nd and 11. Now we're in. Unfortunate range. We'll call this high-low dig. Okay, I'm gonna switch this to the swing because I see Sherman is way off, and all I need is a block. Oh man. Oh man. Much respect. Much respect for reading that. Oh my gosh. I am flirting with disaster. I've done that multiple times. This is going to catch up to me eventually. I have no doubt in my mind.
Maybe a defense been dropping out in his own blitz. He's going to win that battle just about
Man, I mean, he read that perfectly. He came down. I would have done the same thing. I would have tried to catch the interception rather than try and make sure I got the tackle. Nope. You can't have that. All right. I'm going to come out in ISO, then switch to power or toss if need be. He pinches the lineman. Okay. Looks like the ISO should be fine. Freaking Earl Thomas holding up Adrian Peterson. Okay, I have to call the toss here because I don't have an audible for it, but I will audible this down to power zero if need be. All right, he's obviously controlling that outside power. I'm gonna run this weak. HB Sting would have been perfect for that look as well. 4:27 left. Got I need to stop. I gotta tell myself to just wait on the play action. I mean, if he's gonna. If I don't get him in the backfield, it's not a big deal. There I am, trying to hit Steve Thomas Rawls again. Surprised that it worked. Usually against eight formations, I do send the linemen one way. I am going to send them to the strong side on this particular play. All right, I expect he's going to come out with that fullback dive out of the week. Fullback dive out of iPhone, I guess. Dude, just weave right past my dude. That's two stops we haven't gotten so far. Okay. We can't call 3-2-6 versus that. I need to be able to pinch my line. Second and five. I'm gonna call. Dang it. I'm gonna call blitz here. Send my line over to the left. Come on, guys. Ali. I appreciate you getting back there and stuffing it a little bit. You gotta just make that tackle, bro. Because he almost broke free in the backfield, but you also have to love and admire what the defense did. So because I shifted my line over to the left, that gave Ali a free run right down at the play itself. Alright, so this is a pretty big play. I'm going to try and watch the crossers coming this way. Oh, man. Fourth and one. Oh, damn. First and 10. That's why Dime 326 is difficult against the gun formations. Because I can't pinch my line or send them any either direction. Leaves it open to that. Which I should have realized that, because he's done that twice so far. I think that, yeah, I have the wind. So I've got to make it so the field goal is a difficult one. Gonna run C2.
Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. Now a toss. This is Rawls. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. It'll be a gain of 2.
Third ninjas.
The play, but they'll remain a few inches short here with third down looming.
Partner, we know today's NFL rule built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense. As the game goes along, you control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
This will be the 8th play of the drive, and it's 3rd and 8.
Regular half form.
They run with a power back.
Oh my God. we can't get the break versus Lou Roll, or Thomas Roll. We cannot get the break. Consistently falling forward.
No reason to dance around in the backfield, try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
So the D line's going to spread out. They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. Here's Rawls, and he'll get it. And now the Bills are going to stop it as they call a timeout. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground.
That's going to
make it 2nd and 4.
It's going to make it difficult for me to. Well, I can't. I can't. Ice them.
Really long drive here, and
about
a timeout. And the D-line pitching together must be expecting the run. Again, Rawls, he's been busy.
Oh my goodness! Look at this guy! Okay, that's it.
That's a nice pickup on the first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
Wow.
So the offense has it first.
He's freaking just dragging us. Just dragging us. I'm going to send all the linebackers this time. Wow. I mean, not much I can say at this point. I mean, my front 7 is averaging like 80, 85 overall. And he's just dragging all of them. So
they'll run with Rawls. And he's gonna be hemmed in and brought down right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to confirm on what will be.
So we'll just take this as it is.
Everything here, we're gonna get a timeout by the offense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this 4th quarter of play. And this seemingly endless drive continues. They'll give it to him right off the gun. Just a 1-yard pickup there, and it'll be 4th down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. Now the Bills will take another timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break.
Oh, no ice? I guess I just don't know how to ice the kicker. I've tried right before he kicked, but I've tried. Oh, well.
Charles, there's an old saying.
Unfortunate. What?
You're exactly right about that, Brandon. When you look at it and all of your preparation went into winning this week, now you have to absorb a loss and find a way to shake it off.
Yuck. Look at this guy. We're all just abusing us. 6'5", 6". Ay, ay, ay. Let me see this run. Well, take our first L of the year. Had to happen sometime. My goodness. Like, Kyle Williams is breathing on him. And then just perfect spin. You know, it just is what it is. Navarro Bowman. Come on. Where are the sacks? Oh, need to check this out too. Was there anywhere else to go? I wasn't gonna go to Heartline. I mean, he's the only really real option there. Unfortunate. I don't know if he was holding triangle, but if he was, I don't know how they didn't give it to him. He's right in the line. Oh well. Didn't matter in the long run anyways. Alright, well, have a good one, fellas. Peace.